I think we're probably ready to go. Thank you all for coming. I appreciate your attendance, and thank you WCTV Channel 8 for recording the scene. And I want to introduce Mark Rossnagel, who's come from Maine to play piano for us tonight. And I've met Mark because he was sometimes a concert partner of my daughter, who's a singer. And I always enjoyed Mark's playing, and as maybe I might have said, that what's distinctive and unusual that I really noticed is that Mark, why shouldn't everybody be like this? He loves the music that he's playing, and you can, like, you know, what a difference that makes. I have confidence that I usually haven't had any classical pianists, solo pianists playing in here. But I felt really happy to invite Mark, and he's going to speak later on. But I think you're going to start right away with the music. So for at this point, I'll introduce Mark Rossnagel. Thank you, Mark.
Thank you. Thank you.
really grateful to be here.
I like to play my concerts. I usually play concerts in the fall, and I try to play them a few times. And I'm playing in Portland, Maine next week, and that's the last time for this one. So the piece you just heard was a Nocturne by Chopin. It's a late work. If you see the opus number, it's 62, and the next opus number is opus 10. So this much earlier, these pieces I'm going to play. But in general, the theme of this concert is short pieces. The longest of them is maybe 7-8 minutes. I haven't clocked it. And the shortest of them is under 3. And also, they all have a connection to France, mostly a biographical connection. Chopin was Polish on his mother's side, but actually French on his father's side, which I found out recently. So you're allowed to call him a French composer. You're not going to get shot by a musicologist if you call him a French composer. And the other composers are all, you know, born in France. And France was certainly the country of employment for all of those composers. But Chopin first, he's known really for the smaller works. It's his longer works, the sonatas, that people sometimes criticize, and they say that formulaically they're kind of odd. But he really excelled at the salon piece, quote-unquote. And as he got older, as you heard in that first piece, the form becomes harder and harder to follow, and it's very kind of wispy, and it's just kind of vanishing all the time, and then there's new pathways, and they vanish. But then the earlier works, like the Etudes, are much more structurally predictable, but no less beautiful. So I'm going to play 4 of the 12 etudes in Opus 10. If you don't know the Chopin etudes, you have to go listen to them tonight when you go home. There's 2 sets, Opus 10 and Opus 25, and they're really remarkable pieces. And I hope you like them. I'm going to play them all as a set. So if you feel like applauding at all afterwards, if you could just hold it until all 4 of them. Thanks. Thank you.
Thank you.
they call that last one the sunshine etude. It is the most unsunshiny experience to play, I can assure you. So Chopin was French by choice. He moved to France when he was a young man and essentially stayed there the rest of his life. And he found that Paris especially was the kind of artistic environment that was really best for him to flourish. And it was the same with these other composers I'm going to play. So what I'm trying to do in this little second piece of the program
is juxtapose a 21st or 20th century composer, Maurice Ravel, with earlier French composers whom he was influenced by. So I'm going to play two pieces by Ravel, and in between them, the kind of sandwich filling, are two shorter pieces by earlier French composers, Rameau and Couperin. You'll notice that three of these four pieces have titles. The title evokes a mood or a scene. So the Pavane by Ravel, if you are only kind of glancingly familiar with French, you might horrified look at it and say it's a pavane for a dead baby and like, oh, what is this horrible thing? But it's actually, it's meant to be an evocation of the Spanish Infanta, the princess of Spain. And it's meant to be kind of a scene of this princess of Spain dancing at court. He wrote it for the Princess de Polignac, who was a patron of his, one of Ravel's patrons. The two early pieces are from suites for harpsichord. So they didn't have pianos back in the day of Couperin and Rameau, they had harpsichords. And both Rameau and Couperin wrote these little harpsichord suites. And some of the pieces had names, and they were meant to kind of evoke a mood or a scene from mythology. So the Cyclops, you'll have to imagine, you'll have to go back to your Homer Odyssey reading. You know, frankly, I don't know that I envision anything when I'm playing the piece. I'm just trying so hard to play the damn notes that I... you can envision if you want, you can envision. But the other piece, the piece by Couperin, Sœur Monique, is supposed to be just a depiction of a little nun. And I think it is the cutest, most adorable thing. And I really do enjoy playing that one. Couperin's a wonderful composer. So, and then the last piece is from a suite that Ravel wrote, and the suite is called Le Tombeau de Couperin, and it is both an homage to François Couperin, whose keyboard style Ravel really enjoyed, and each movement of this suite was dedicated to a friend who Ravel lost in World War I. Mm-hmm. So Ravel, even though he was a very short, probably shorter than me, kind of very dandyish, very delicate young man, he wanted so badly to participate in the war effort, and he became an ambulance driver. And I think he must have seen some really horrible things because it really marked him for the rest of his life. He remembered it. And this suite, Le Tombeau de Couperin, was begun before the war but finished after the war. So something of that time must have gotten in there. And I think that this toccata brings to mind gunfire, kind of a battle scene. So. It's a short program. I'm going to play these four pieces all the way through, but I don't need to play them as a set. So if you need to move around or whatever in between, that's fine. And there's liquor back there. And thank you again for having me. And if you want to learn more about the pieces, we can talk after the concert. Thanks again. thank you again for coming. I really appreciate such a lovely audience. And if you have friends in Portland, Maine, or the surrounding area, please let them know. The concert is October 5th. It's a week from today. at 7:30 at night at the First Parish Church on 425 Congress Street. And a portion of the proceeds will benefit Planned Parenthood of Portland. So I'm very looking forward to that. So thank you again.
Thank you, Sonny. Thank you, Mark.
Thank you, WCTV. Much appreciated.